Good day, everybody. In this video, I'm going to explain how we design a ditch to catch fallen rocks from the top of the slope. To do that, we're going to use the chart which is shown here. So the chart was introduced by Ritchie in 1963. For this chart, we use slope height. So this is what we need to estimate during site investigation. And we can also estimate slope angle. That will be very useful to design this catchment, right? So let's look at this example. It's a little bit, again, a simple example, but it will show you how the chart works. So let's say we're going to the site and we'll look at the slope geometry, and it's kind of pretty simple. So we can estimate the height of the slope is 20 meters. Also, we notice there is lots of loose rocks right on the edge of the slope that can potentially bounce down or roll down and go all the way here. Maybe we have a house here or something. So we just want to make sure that we will do some preventive measures before this rockfall happens. So one of the things that we can do, it's a ditch, so it's a catchment. So typically we just excavate some part here, and when rocks bounce or roll down, they're just going to be caught in this catchment. Usually at the bottom we put some soft material, maybe even gravel, so that we can decrease the kinematic energy from the falling rocks. So we need to know these two values, which is the depth of this catchment, the ditch, and the width. And these two values depend on the slope height and the angle. So you will see that for this particular case, we have 20 meters. A slope height, and we also need to estimate the angle. So slope angle will be this one. It's called alpha. All right. So we need to estimate the angle, and to estimate the angle, we just use simple geology, geometry. Sorry, geology is also pretty simple. Geology is sandstone, but in this case, it doesn't matter. What only matters the slope inclination and the height. Okay, so let's write down the tangent alpha. That will be height, which is 20 meters, divided by this part, right, which is given 22.2 meters. So that will be approximately 0.9. And tangent of 0.9 will give us that angle. It's about 42 degrees. So it's kind of a steep angle, right? So this is equal to 42 degrees. Now let's look at the chart. So for the chart, we have a slope height and it's 20 here. And the angle is 42. Well, if you look at the chart, that's actually not a very steep angle, right? We have lots of values which are greater than 40. So 42, it's, I believe, somewhere here. Okay, I guess I made this example to make it easier for myself. So this is the point. You see how nice this point is sitting on both of the lines. So we have a dotted line that will give us width. And in this case, let's just trace. What is this? What does it say? It says 4.57, correct? So we know that in this case, width, and will be 4.57 meters, and the depth, that's the solid line. Let's trace it again. So this is 1.83. Okay, so I probably made a simple example for myself. So if you look at data and you point, for example, somewhere here, then it's not that simple. You will have to do some interpolation. So like, for example, for depth, you interpolate between this two lines, and this one is 2.13, and this one's 1.93. So you just have to decide which value will be in between. And then for the width, you have again these two lines. So stretch can draw. Okay, so well, let's probably go this way. So you have to interpolate between 6.1 and 4.57. So okay, so this was actually a bit simple example. This means that if we wanna build the catchment, the ditch, so the width will be around 4.57 meters, and we have to excavate it 1.83 meters. That will be the depth. Well, thanks for watching this video. I hope that now you'll be able to design a ditch, or at least have a good idea how it's done. Have a nice day. Bye.